Hey everyone, welcome back to String Cheese and Applesauce, where today we're going to review the LEGO City City Square set. This is set number 60097, and me personally, this is the largest LEGO City set that I've ever built. I don't know if it's the largest one ever made, but it is 1,683 pieces. So, like I said, it's the biggest one that I've personally built. The first thing we want to look at is this set came with 10 instruction books. So they're basically broken down. It's actually pretty easy to follow along. They're broken down into each little piece is more or less one instruction book, with the exception of the LEGO City Service Center / car dealership back there. That one was broken down into two instruction books. So I did videos of the build of this entire set, and I broke it down per instruction book. There's links down below if you want to check it out. It's actually on my other channel, The Hidden Brick, where all I do is LEGO builds. But let's go ahead and look at all the details of this set. So just kind of big picture here before we start to zoom in and look at everything else. This is more or less supposed to be a city square where there's a lot of different industries or businesses, a lot of stuff going on in the downtown city. So we have two buildings, we have a train stop, we have a little coffee stand, and we have a tow truck, a delivery truck, a news helicopter, and then a few other small helicopters, and of course the main means of transportation, the train. And then there's a few other small accessories. So let's go ahead and jump right in and look at each one of these individual buildings. And we'll look at the minifigures too as we get there, because they're not really super special minifigures. It's just a lot of generic LEGO City figures. So let's start looking at each piece right now. So I'm going to show you these individual elements kind of in the sequential order that they were built in the instruction book. So the first thing is this small little accessory piece, and it comes with a little dog, and there's no leash or anything for the dog, so it's just a city dog. And it's one of the cool newer husky style dogs, so it's nice having this if you don't have any of those yet, but they're starting to appear in more and more sets. So the hot dog stand, this is pretty cool. There was a poly bag hot dog stand that came out last year that is extremely similar to this. There's just a few slight variations, but either way, it's a neat small little build. The hot dog sticker on there to help, you know, show you that it is a hot dog stand. And then you have the employee, and he has his little tongs that can grab onto the hot dog that's on the grill. The little slotted tile piece, that's the grill. And then there's the little bar thing that he can hold on to and push his stand around. So that's the hot dog stand. So the next piece that we started to build was the car repair shop. So let me pull it over here. And this is it. So there was two portions to this build. There was the repair shop portion, and then the car dealership portion over here, and they're actually held together with some Technic pins. So you can see this detail is something that's done on a lot of modulars or larger building sets, like the Creator sets, where they use the Technic pins to connect the two sides together. So the first portion that was built was this auto repair shop. So you have a cool little ramp that you can drive up, and once you're up there, you can see there's a little Technic piece over here that you can pull over and it will lift up the car. So it's this cool little car lift, and it's all just some Technic pieces that are used to lift it up and push it back down. So it is built really close to this wall, and I've noticed when I've been moving it, and even when the kids play with it, this portion right here does get snagged right on the bricks sometimes. You see it's kind of hitting it there. You have to move stuff around to get it to go all the way down. So it's a slight design flaw, but it's really not that bad. It's manageable. You can see as we go around the corner, there's a little reception desk in there where you can pay for your car services. So there's a little computer pad and a screen there. Nothing really else. There's a clear kind of storefront entry there. A lot of stickers on this portion. So all of these tread pieces here are all stickers. You have this little vertical sign that's all stickered. And then you have this services sign over here where it shows, looks like oil change, tire rotation, and battery check or battery change. That's a sticker. Sticker up here, sticker up there. So a lot of stickers on the set. There's also a cool little car vehicle thing. We have a person in here. Let me take her out. So this will be the first minifigure that we look at. So this is your standard kind of Lego City female figure. Plain white pants, black hair with it pulled in a ponytail, just a standard little smile, and the dark bluish gray torso with a little scarf printed around it. So we've seen this combination of pieces in a lot of sets, so nothing really new there. So there's a few cars in this set, and this is the first one, and they're really, really similar as far as the size and really the builds. They're pretty similar. Just has the rooftop that you pull off, basic interior with just a steering wheel. You can fit pretty much just one minifigure in there. And that's really it. There's no, you know, operable trunks or anything. It's just a standard car. So the part that connects to this repair shop is the car dealership. And there's some cool details about this. Now, the first thing you notice, there's really no stickers on this portion. So you kind of have to use your imagination that it's the dealership. But I'm calling it the dealership because look at this. The doors slide open and you have this really cool showroom where you have a car in here. And then they can close. So it's like when they're open for business, showing off the cars, they open the doors. Top one doesn't do that because it's a upper showroom. If you pull it around, and the instructions and even the box shows another car up in here. How they get it up there, that's up to you to decide. It's just there's only so much they can build with this many buildings, so there's a level of incompleteness with some of these buildings. So we have the second car right here, and this is the convertible car. But similar to the black car, really all it's missing is the roof and the little portion on the back to connect the roof. It's extremely similar. All it is basic interior with a steering wheel. There's really nothing else operable on it. You'll notice that all of the cars do have stickered license plates, and they all end in the number 60097, which is the set number, but there's two letters before each one of those numbers. So it's typically those are initials to the people that designed the set. So this one is MM60097 and this one is HS60097. So could be initials, we don't know. And then also in the showroom there's a little rack of tires. So if you want to upgrade the tires on your or the tires and wheels, because they are separate, they're different wheels. You can purchase upgraded wheels and tires for your car. So that is the showroom portion. And this detail here, the sliding doors, is probably the coolest detail about this combination build piece. So the next thing we built was this cool little Lego store. And it's really just a storefront. You have the three windows with the door on the front, and then we have these masonry bricks going up. We have a cool little street light kind of attached to the side here with a bus stop sign. Now that is a stickered piece, as every piece you see decorated in this set is stickered. With the exception of, and we'll look at them in there, let's go ahead and look now, is all of the see if I get this right. Zoom in. All of your Lego sets. So these are really cool tiles. These are all printed tiles, and they're just attached to a plate. So I'll pull one of these off. So these are actually prints of real Lego City sets. So this is the Lego City Swamp Police Pontoon Helicopter Chase set, whatever it's called. I'm paraphrasing, but if you have this set or recognize the box, it's actually a pretty good representation of it. And then that is the Lego City Bulldozer set. And then over here we have the Lego City, oh, that's the tow truck. No, that's the ATV set, the Lego City ATV. And that's it. They repeat all three of those tiles throughout the whole set. So there's those three Lego City sets are being sold in the Lego store. We have a little statue right there. And then check this out, a cool little mini pick-a-brick wall. So I did a mock on a pick-a-brick wall for a Saturday night stream, and mine was a little bit bigger than this, but it looked very similar to it. And then here is the checkout counter. Now you'll see that on the inside here, this is a two-story high space. So from the outside looking in, you see the castle minifigure and the Lego space minifigure. Those are actually just, I guess, what you'd call mannequins or something else that's brick built. So they're not people on the second floor looking out. It's actually supposed to be like a display item. So that's a pretty cool little Lego City piece. And there is one cool little thing that I want to show you. There's a rooftop AC unit. And there's not many rooftop details on a lot of buildings in general. Excuse me. So it's kind of cool having a rooftop detail. It's random that they put it in this set, but I would expect it in a, say, a modular building type set. But hey, I'll take it. It's something that, you know, that's why you build these sets. Something always surprises you. It's like, oh, that's a cool little detail. So that's the Lego store. Next little build, it accompanies the Lego store, and that is the Lego delivery truck. And this delivery truck is actually delivering Lego sets. So it's a basic yellow delivery truck. Nothing real fancy about it. There is a delivery driver, and see, he's wearing the yellow torso or yellow shirt, and he has the Lego print on the back. That's pretty cool. He's wearing the red baseball cap and just has a little printed shirt. It's supposed to be a name badge there, but there's no name on it. So once again, stickers all the way around, and then there's two doors on the back you can open, and there should be some Lego sets in here. Yep, so there's a hand truck and some more Lego sets. We've got the bulldozer set and the swamp police set, and you can see how you can easily put them on the hand truck, and the guy can push them up to the store. So that's our basic delivery truck. There are all those guys back in there. So one thing I forgot before we got into the Lego store was this is another vehicle that was built right after the car dealership and repair shop. It is the flatbed tow truck. So it's a pretty cool little build. Now, Lego City did come out with a flatbed truck not too long ago, and this one is similar. There are some differences. I think this one is actually a little bit more simplified. There's less as far as what's going on back here than the original one, but it's very similar to any Lego City truck, or you know, those $20 sets that come out a lot. Stickers all the way around. I mean, literally everything. I mean, there's three sticker sheets in the set, so it's crazy how many stickers are in here. And then you can see the back portion is just hinged. Now, when I initially built this, I accidentally built one stud too long. I had one piece off, and it messed up the hinged flatbed truck portion, but I fixed it afterwards. So if you watch the build video of this, you may notice that initially my flatbed only tipped like this far because it was hitting a stud. But like I said, I fixed that since then. There is the third and final car right here. It's another convertible one. You can see it's already bought some Lego and it's got it in the trunk there. Now, here's the little string and hook already attached to it. So similar to the previous flatbed truck, you basically just connect the hook and then reel it in like you're fishing for cars. And once you get it up there, it's good to go. So something interesting about this hook, let me go ahead and turn this around. You can see there is a modified plate with this little clip that you can hook it on. So you can see the hook fits perfectly on there. But the instructions actually show there's studs on the hook here on the side to actually put that stud inside this little open hole piece on the bottom of that axle brick. And what that will do is allow you to reel it in a little bit easier. I'd prefer to hook it on like an actual hook, but you can see when you reel it all the way in, the front bumper piece is literally touching that reel. So if you have the hook there, it would hang out like about this far, so it wouldn't actually pull all the way up on the flatbed truck. So it's a slight design flaw. It's a little too short for these small cars. They're not even really big cars. So if you have a bigger car, it won't fit on there at all. So that's the tow truck. Next up, we're gonna look at, here's another little accessory thing. This actually came with the first bag. It's a pizza delivery guy. He's got boxes of pizza on the back of his moped, and he is zooming off, and they're kind of starting to fall off. He's going so fast. Basic city minifigure. He's kind of got the little determined face. He's like, gotta deliver these pizzas. And he's got the red, white, and green kind of striped outfit. Kind of the standard Italian pizza color or pizza restaurant colors. Got this bucket handle. That's the kickstand. So when he's zooming around, he folds it up underneath there and you can see that it rolls around just fine. And then when he's ready to park it, you can pull it down and it'll stand up straight. So that's our pizza delivery guy. All right, next up, let's go ahead and look at the coffee chain. So from reading comments on my Instagram and the build videos, this is one of the more popular elements that people have either wanted or they just want to see this portion of the build. And the reason why is obviously the coffee chain. So the coffee chain is something that we first saw in the Lego movie where, you know, it was awesome to buy a $40 cup of coffee. So there's never really been any building that is similar to that till now. And unfortunately, this is just a coffee kiosk. It's not even really the full coffee chain building that we saw in the Lego movie, which I would have preferred a larger coffee chain or coffee shop, you know, kind of like a Starbucks or a Dunkin' Donuts, something bigger in lieu of, say, the car dealership, you know, just had a more substantial build of this and less of a car dealership building. I would have taken that trade off, but we'll take it either way. So all it really is there's a little coffee grinder in here. There's a little brewing station right behind there and one coffee employee. There's a I guess, what is a little venti cup or something, a little styrofoam cup with a lid, and then two coffee mugs. And that's really it. The cool little coffee chain sticker. There's a bench or a, what do you call it, picnic table over here with an umbrella. And that's really it. There's a cool little bike stand. So all this really is this window bar piece that's not in a window frame. It's folded down, and you can put the bike inside one of those little slots. So you can, has room for three bikes, which is cool. That's it for the coffee chain. I mean, it's a little underwhelming, but it's something. Interestingly enough, the Lego minifigure in here, the worker, looks almost identical to the collectible minifigure from the collectible minifigure series of the Lego movie. With the exception of the name badge, doesn't have a name on it, whereas the collectible minifigure did have a name on it. And the little coffee chain logo that's on the front of the worker's apron there is on the center on this one, and on the collectible minifigure, it's up kind of in the corner of that apron. So, real similar to the collectible minifigure, but not quite identical. So that's the coffee chain. So what's next? Let's go ahead and look at the train station first, and then we'll look at the train itself. So here is the train station, and it's okay. It's a smaller, it's probably one of the smallest little builds as far as part wise. Maybe the coffee chain is equal parts. They're both pretty small, but what we have here is a little covered seating area that train passengers can wait. We have all of these stickered pieces here. There's the little kiosks where you can buy your train ticket, and it's identical on the other side. There are two stickered clocks, which I think are pretty cool. They're digital clocks. Time's reading 12:15 right now. And then the little orange sticker here kind of shows you the little train map. So you, typically the straight line is the route, and then the dots are all the stops. So that's pretty cool. There's a little trash can bucket here, and then this extremely boring straight up tree trunk with some foliage at the top. So never really a fan of this style of tree where it's just the round 2x2s going all the way up. I like the trees that have some, you know, sloped bricks kind of forming the trunk, and then at the top they have the arched bricks to actually form the top of the tree. But hey, it's a Lego City set. They usually don't get into that much detail. There is also a little newsstand that has newspapers. These are printed tiles, so these are some of the few printed pieces. And it's a standard tile that we've seen in other sets before. The sticker on this one is not a standard one. It says the Daily Lego News. So there's your little newspaper stand. So you can grab a paper while you're waiting for the train. So that leads us to the train. And look at that. I was moving this and the tree just popped right off. So, not a fan of that tree. So here is the train. So there's, it's basically a standard, I guess, modern train that you would see in a lot of cities. It has the little bar up here that attaches to the overhead power line. So it's an electric train. It actually does have train wheels on the bottom. Does not come with any sort of track. So you basically just roll it around on the floor, the table, wherever you're playing with it. It's designed with all glass on the sides. Both sides are exactly the same, and black and orange yellow scheme. Yellow scheme? Black and orange color scheme. I don't know why I said yellow scheme. Maybe it's because of the yellow stickers. I'm thinking as I'm talking, getting ahead of myself. So the stickers are yellow, and I don't know if you can tell, but there are some stickers printed on or stickered to this window But since they're yellow and this is like this dark gray trans piece, you really can't see them too well. So very interesting there. You do have a driver's compartment at the front. So this is your city driver. He's wearing a, pull him out, kind of the public transportation uniform. That little symbol there, the circle with the two arrows to the side, that's kind of the Lego City symbol for train route or bus route. He has a little pocket with a paper and a pen, and kind of got the nerdy glasses going on. Cool little maroon hat. Conductor hat, basically. So that's the train driver. So let's open up the train doors, show you what's going on the inside. I was trying to open it too low. So you can see they open up kind of like the DeLorean time machine. I guess they call these gull wing doors, where they open from the bottom up, and you have four seats on each one, and the back one is identical. We do have a couple minifigures in here that were going for a ride. So this is a Lego City kid. You see nothing special here. We've seen this torso many times. Standard Lego City hat. Got the short legs that are non-posable, so they cannot sit in this train. They actually have to stand, since these short legs don't have a sitting position. And he has a bag from the Lego store. So he went to the Lego store. He's extremely happy. He's got Lego. He's going home. He's going to make a YouTube video. And then we have this girl. And it's a young girl. That's the short legs indicate that. Once again, standard torso we've seen before. Hairpiece we've seen before. Face seen before. And she has visited the hot dog stand because she has a hot dog in her hand. And she's eating on her way home, or wherever she's going in the train. So you can see the short guys, or the kids, since their legs don't pose, they have to stand up in the train. So that's a design flaw with those short legs. I don't think there's really anything to be done too much about that. This middle portion of the articulated train is, front popped off. You can see it has a bike sticker on there. So that's where a rider can put their bike, close that in there, and when they go to their next stop, they can pull the bike out and bike around the city. So the front or the back, I mean, they're identical. These two are identical. They're just pushed back to back. You can see there's some more minifigures in there, and they're actually in their sitting position. Let me rotate this around. So kids have been playing with this. So this is more or less all the minifigures we're looking at is kind of where they left them off at. So here's a Lego store employee. You see he's got the beard, the yellow torso with the Lego logo printed on the back, the glasses and the brown hair, and the black pants. And then this is a employee at the service center or the auto repair area. So got the baseball cap, his work jacket, and a manly black beard there. Nothing printed on the back of the torso. So that's the other minifigure. Then we also have one more employee. This is probably, so these two guys probably are interchangeable between the flatbed driver and the city service center employee. So they're both basically in their work outfit. This guy's probably the service center guy, because you can see at the very top of his overalls, there's some wrenches sticking out of his pocket. So he probably works on the cars, but he could also be the flatbed driver and he could be the employee. So They're interchangeable, and that's what's good about the Lego City minifigures in general, is they're so generic I mean, there's very few that are so specific like this one. He's got the Lego shirt on it, so he's more than likely the Lego store employee. But with a lot of the figures being genericized, they can be really used as anything. You know, whatever your imagination think of, they can be part of the Lego City in their own way. So those are more minifigures. We do have, so that's the train. We do have one more piece to look at. Move these guys back here. And this was the last little thing that was built. And it's basically a news helicopter, not to be confused with a police helicopter. So the kids, when they were playing with it, they're so used to Lego City Police and Lego City Fire. I mean, they just really just wear out those themes that the kids started playing with this, and they're like, "The police are gonna get you." I'm like, no, it's not a police helicopter. It's a news helicopter." And you can see right there on the side, there's a sticker, and it's got a little globe shape, and it says TV 6 Plus. So it's the world news. And 6 Plus, I guess that's for the age range, but either way. There's a camera hanging off the side of this helicopter, and it's got the old style tape reel. I would think modern day cameras would be digital and have some sort of hard drive or electronic feed that goes to the studio, but hey, it's Lego City. They do what they want. So it's basically a city helicopter pilot or news helicopter pilot. He doesn't have anything on his torso that says news. There's really just like a name badge and then this little pilot wing type decoration right there on the side. Of course, he has his aviator sunglasses on, so the sun doesn't get in his eyes. A little bit of printing on the back of the torso. And then, of course, the helmet with the visor. So that's your news helicopter pilot. The helicopter itself is what I would say par for Lego City helicopters. They're usually pretty minimal as far as the builds. It's really just these pre-molded little sled pieces, and then a typical little back tail and a little rotor piece with just a few plates on it to represent the blades at the top. That's really it for the news helicopter. So that's looking at each individual piece. All right, so we've looked at everything, and when you start to look at everything individually, nothing really stands out as wow, this is really cool, I love this, with the exception of probably the public transportation train. That's actually the most complete model in my opinion. All that's really lacking is the track or something to, you know, try to drive it around on. It'd be impossible to make, I mean, it wouldn't be impossible, but it would be out of scale if you had like an oval track or something, and it would basically dwarf the size of the city square itself. So, I think for an adult, this set leaves a lot of things missing as far as the way there's just kind of these little bitty pieces and nothing really whole and complete. But I can tell you from the way my kids have been playing with it, they absolutely love it, and it's a very, very high playability factor. They don't really even seem to care that nothing really is complete. You know, it's just like, oh, look at all these cool things to play with. So for kids, and granted, this is what these sets are marketed towards is kids. They absolutely love it. It's probably a perfect set with the exception of it's enormous and highly expensive, you know, at $120, $130, depending on where you get it. That's kind of out of kids' price range, but hey, Christmas is coming up, so if you're looking at getting this for a kid, it is probably going to be the best gift they've ever received, ever, ever, ever. So that's my thoughts. Cool set. Check it out, especially if you're into Lego City. It's definitely something you have to have. Thanks again for watching. Make sure to check out the builds if you want to see those. There's links down below, and we will see you next time.